Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. When we were young, maybe all of us were taught that heaven is a place in the skies or a paradise with abundant fruit-bearing trees, unlimited food supplies, all white, with clouds, stairs, with Saint Peter holding the keys, all the saints and good people in there, and God the Father with a thick mustache and beard welcoming us, isn't it? Then we realize as we grow up that there's no place up there in the clouds. Heaven is more or less a state of fulfillment and absolute joy and peace with God, which the saints enjoy because of living righteously on earth. Ang langit ay walang hanggang kaligayahan kasama ang Diyos. In the same way, dear brothers and sisters, people in Jesus' time misconstrued the kingdom of God as an earthly kingdom. They all expected that the Messiah and His kingdom were going to be political and earthly. So after the multiplication of the loaves, if you could still remember, the people wanted to make Jesus king through their mother, si John, tsaka si James, no? Nagtanong yung kanilang nanay, pwede bang maupo yung isa sa kaliwa, yung isa sa kanan? On another occasion, Jesus caught the apostles debating, sino ang pinakadakila sa ating lahat? All of them pointing out to an earthly kingdom. Kahit sa Last Supper, yun pa rin ang tanong nila sa bawat isa, sino ang pinakadakila sa ating lahat? And Jesus made an example kung sino ang kayang maghugas ng paa ng bawat isa, siya ang pinakadakila sa kaharian ng Diyos. Dear brothers and sisters, many times, we forget that the kingdom of God is already happening on earth. It is not just up there and at the end of time. It is not a future reality, but it begins right now. The moment we celebrate the Eucharist, it's the kingdom of God happening. Whenever there's peace and reconciliation with God through the sacrament of confession and with one another, that's the kingdom of God happening. When someone forgives a lifelong bitterness and hatred in his heart, the kingdom of God happens. When we become sensitive to those in need and help who are poor, that's the kingdom of God again. Whenever justice is served, it's the kingdom of God. When mercy and compassion reign above all, that's the kingdom of God on earth. Dear friends, the kingdom of God is not just a future reality. It is happening now, although not complete. Jesus, when He was incarnated and lived like us, opened to us the gates to the kingdom of God. Now, how do you plan to enter God's kingdom today? We have so many ways, and it's up to us. Amen.